my buddy was like, dude, painting isn't for everybody. Maybe you just leave the painting to us because you clearly don't have it. And I'm like, wow, that's a pretty messed up thing to say to somebody. Until I was in middle school, me and a couple friends would just start drawing graffiti in our notebooks. For no real reason, we just would like to draw a lot. We had this wall in the backyard. So, not wanting to break the law, we'd just go in the backyard. We'll save up all our money, go buy spray paint, go in our backyard and just paint. And it was not good. But we just kept on painting with spray cans in the backyard. Just a random wall. And little by little, we started getting better at it. We kept doing that. Then we started doing, you know, productions, whether it was a paintball place that had us come in and just do some artwork on their walls. We go to a train yard, do some stuff we probably shouldn't have been doing. But we were kids, we didn't know any better. We were about 15, 16 years old at that point and kept doing that. Fast forward about, I don't know how many years later, a buddy and I were hanging out. I just got the urge to paint, to do some more graffiti, but you know, I was 20 something years old at this point. Wasn't gonna go vandalize anything. So we went to Walmart, we picked up some canvas, picked up some paint markers, some paint, went back to my house, staring at a blank canvas, I painted a redfish tail. I don't know why, I just did. I mean, I've been a fisherman my whole life. I've been doing art my whole life. It just kind of made sense. It's what I wanted to do. I did a redfish tail. I went to work the next day and my buddy was like, dude, painting isn't for everybody. Maybe you just leave the painting to us because you clearly don't have it. And I'm like, wow, that's a pretty messed up thing to say to somebody. So I just told myself, all right, I wanted to understand how to make the paint and the canvas work together, because I could paint on boats, I could paint on cars, I could paint on walls, I could paint on trains, but on canvas, for whatever reason, the texture was just different and it kind of threw me off. So I picked up these little canvas cars they sold at Walmart that had the same texture of canvas. My first two paintings were redfish, and then I did a bonefish one as well. Didn't think much of it. I posted it on Facebook, and immediately I started getting bombarded by people commenting and then messaging me with offers for it. And I was like, what? People actually want to buy this stuff? So I wasn't planning on selling any of it, but one guy just made an offer for all the canvases I had done that I couldn't say no to. So sold them the canvases. I was stoked. I thought, crap, I was able to trick this guy into buying some drawings on canvas. And I went back to work. I told my buddy, and he was like, are you kidding me? Maybe I should start painting fish. Maybe I should start painting fish. And I kept painting fish because it's what comes natural to me. I'm a fisherman. And 2 months later, I was able to quit my job and start doing art full time. And here I am. It's been a few years. It's been a lot of fun. It's taken me a lot of places, and I've seen a lot of cool things that I probably never would have seen if I would have kept working in a body shop, painting cars, painting boats. So yeah, I'm stoked to see where the, you know, where the fish art, fishing, kayak fishing takes me now, because it just opened up a whole new avenue as far as getting to some of these fishing grounds, and I get to now, you know, portray new things that I probably wouldn't have seen on a boat, because on a boat you're kind of flying past everything. On a kayak you gotta like take it all in. You're going much slower. So it's pretty cool, a lot more visual stuff to see, a lot more visual stuff to paint, so I'm pretty stoked now.